Hi, we're here for another YouTube video. This time we're going to talk a little bit about the new Line 6 Relay G90 rack mount unit. I'm going to try and cover some of the less talked about features. The first thing that I'd like to mention is that they're really, really well made. The transmitters themselves are compact, a really unobtrusive antenna. And they last forever on batteries. You can get 7 to 8 hours out of a good set of batteries anyway. Same goes for the transmitter. Well built, nice sturdy antennas. Along the back panel, we've got a 1/4 inch out for connection to a regular amplifier. We've also got a balanced out, so if you're using acoustic guitar, you can go straight into the PA or the desk without having to use a DI box. We've also got a separate tuner output, which is parallel to your main outs and is always active. And the cool thing about that is that via the transmitter, you can actually mute the transmitter and it'll still transmit a signal or still send a signal through the tuner out, so you can essentially, you've got a tuning mute on the transmitter. 12 digital channels to work with. The cool thing is that you can actually select between two channels and AB between them. So if you're a guitar player that has two guitars, rather than have to get two separate wireless systems, you can actually have two transmitters, and via the menu, if we can see this, you select the setup and you select the toggle mode. So you select that, okay, you choose your first channel. So we'll go channel 2 is what the first guitar is, like that. You then go to the next channel, let's say your next channel you're going to want to make, and you'll notice that it doesn't let you select channel 2 at all. So if you've already got one selected, you can't do it twice. Channel 3, so we'll go, the second channel is second guitar is channel 3. You select that. Okay, you can exit that. Now we've now got here channel 2. Okay, hit that. You go into your next guitar. So it's literally a matter of picking up one guitar, hitting this button, and you're now toggling between your two channels. So really, really easy to do, because we all like rack gear that looks pretty and has lights, so you can change the color of the backlight. Now, I don't know about you, but that's cool. Huh? Yeah. Yeah. Look red. That is wild. Let's go pink, because I'm comfortable with my sexuality. With traditional wireless systems, if you're using multiple systems, you generally need to use some sort of antenna combiner. Rather than running a separate antenna off each unit, those units can usually be usually either at least as expensive as the wirelesses themselves or more expensive. With these, you don't need to do that. You can literally daisy chain the antennas in these. So if you've got one system, you connect the antenna up to the next unit and then up to the next unit, and whatever the last unit is in that chain is what the antenna gets connected to. So you're cutting out quite a lot of expense and allowing a lot of room for future expansion with this. Also, we've got on the front here, we've got like meters, LED meters for your battery level. So you've got the RF here. So obviously we're gonna have quite a lot of RF at this distance. We've also got a battery meter. So it'll tell you how much you've got left. Also, if you zoom in on the transmitter here, it gives you a reading in hours and minutes of how long you've got, which is pretty handy. So you've got 8 hours and 40 minutes left. I actually own and use one of these all the time, and I've bought a lot of gear, so you can rest assured that when I say that, I have used and owned everything that I've talked about in the video. So I can't recommend these highly enough. They're extremely robust, very cheap for what they are. They, in my opinion, blow everything else out of the water for a guitar wireless. Another thing I'll quickly mention is the cable tone, which is a pretty talked about feature in these systems. It basically simulates the capacitance that you get with cables. So as you increase the cable tone setting, you it adds capacitance basically. So it rolls off a little bit of top end, a little bit of low end, and just gives you back the character in the guitar sound that doing that would give you. They also do these in, they do microphone versions, lapel, and I'm actually using the lapel to record to do this video with. So they're very reliable, they sound great, they're made well, they've got huge antennas, you can link them, you can do all sorts of crazy stuff. Great units, very cool units. Also for bass players out there, because there's no companding, okay, so the signal isn't squashed down and then expanded again, you retain all of your dynamic range. So for those bass players who have tried wireless systems over the years, tried every new one but have been disappointed, this is the one to try. If you can't, if you think that you're losing signal with this, give up on wirelesses. Bass players, this is one you want to try.